cells, you have just learned about the basic unit of life, which is what we call cells. In other words, if you were to take a person or any living organism and break them down to that very smallest component that is still living, that is called a cell. And there's all different types of cells, even in your own body. But no matter what type of organism it is, what type of cell it is, we can classify it in two broad categories. And that is prokaryotes or eukaryotes. And there's some things that set these two types of cells apart that we're gonna talk about today. But I'm gonna draw them out for you so you can actually see it. So let's first talk about the size. Prokaryotes are a lot smaller than eukaryotes. So I'm gonna draw a structure on the very outside of every single cell, and that goes for prokaryotes and eukaryotes, and that's called the cell membrane. And notice that I drew prokaryotes smaller than eukaryotes. That's because they are like a lot smaller. But this outside structure is called a cell membrane, and both types of cells have this. The cell membrane, or the plasma membrane, is that structure that's on the very outside of cells, and it actually controls what's going to go inside and outside of the cells. And it's very selective. It only lets in what the cell needs and keeps out things that it doesn't need. And it will push things out that the cell needs to get rid of, like waste. And it'll prevent things from exiting that it needs to keep in. So it's really important to all living organisms. The other thing that both cells have in common is this inside jelly-like substance that everything else inside of the cell is floating in, and that is called the cytoplasm. The other important structure that all cells have or contain is called DNA. This is their genetic material. It's the blueprint that provides all the instructions to the cells for their functions and how to make important structures. So both prokaryotes and eukaryotes have this important structure, DNA. Now here is the first thing that we're going to talk about that sets the two apart, and it's really important. Eukaryotes have their DNA stored in a nucleus. And what a nucleus is, it's a membrane-bound organelle. And actually, eukaryotes have a lot of other types of organelles as well. Things like, and you don't have to know these now, but I'll list them for you anyways, things like endoplasmic reticulum, or ER, some is smooth and some is rough because it has these structures called ribosomes on it. They also have things like Golgi apparatuses, lysosomes, and mitochondria, along with some other things. But eukaryotes are the only type of cells that have these membrane-bound organelles. Prokaryotes lack these, and that's what really sets the two apart. One last structure that I wanted to share with you that both cells have is called ribosomes. So these are little tiny structures within the cell, and these structures are actually going to be what produces proteins or synthesizes proteins, and those are called ribosomes. Okay, so to recap, prokaryotes are smaller. They have a cell membrane, DNA, cytoplasm, and ribosomes just like eukaryotes do, but they have no nucleus or other membrane-bound organelles. So a good way to remember this is pro means no. Eukaryotes have a cell membrane, DNA, cytoplasm, and ribosomes just like prokaryotes do, but they're larger and more complex, and so they store their DNA in a nucleus, and they have tons of membrane-bound organelles that have specific jobs. So a good way to remember this is you rhymes with do have a nucleus.